EEAT stands for experience, expertise, authoritativeness, and trustworthiness. And it's a really important factor to consider if you want your pages to rank high in search results. You know, it used to be EAT, just EAT, and then Google added the experience to it. So now it's EEAT, which is like super hard to pronounce. In this video, we will dig into each criterion individually and share top ways you can improve your content so it meets user needs and ranks higher in Google. This will include three SEMrush tools that can help you with EEAT SEO right now. Okay, let's start by talking a little bit more about EEAT and why it even exists. Google's most important product to date is search. And because they want us all to find the relevant, high-quality information we are looking for when we type stuff into that little blank box, Google is constantly making improvements to its search products. Each of these changes goes through a rigorous evaluation process, including something called a search quality test. This is when Google hires real human search, human beings, quality raters from all over the world to assess the quality of search results using a set of guidelines. And guess what they use to assess page quality? That's right, EEAT. Now, it's important to highlight that EEAT is not a ranking factor, meaning that it is not part of Google's algorithm, nor does it solely determine the order in which search results are displayed. In their overview of search quality rater guidelines, Google writes that no single source of information, like a search quality rating, can capture every dimension that's important for a task as complex as ranking. And I quote, EEAT is just one of many inputs that determine rank, but it's a really important one, which is why I'm telling you all about it in this video. Now, let's dive into the four components of Google EEAT and how you can improve them for your website. First, experience. Quality content often demonstrates the creator's first-hand experience with the subject matter. This helps prove that suggestions are tried and tested and that insights are actually authentic. Now, check out this review for the board game Wingspan. The author in this blog post talks about their own personal experiences and opinions with this game and provides unique product photos to prove that they actually played Wingspan. Next up is expertise. Search quality raters must determine whether authors have topical expertise. In other words, if they have the knowledge, the qualifications, and the credentials to give reliable information. Now, expertise often overlaps or is confused with experience. I know I do it all the time, but they're actually not the same thing. Consider the topic of saving money. Some people want financial advice from an accredited professional, that is expertise. Others want real life examples and strategies that worked for their peers. That's experience. Both types of content can offer value to searchers, so both can perform well under Google EEAT. Okay, number three is authoritativeness. Authoritativeness refers to your overall reputation in your industry, especially among experts and influencers in your niche. Now, Google quality raters are instructed to review the authoritativeness of the creator, the content, and the website. For example, an article on abdominal pain from WebMD is authoritative because WebMD is a well-known publication for medical advice. The authors, WebMD editorial contributors, are wellness professionals. They ask an expert, usually a doctor, to check their content for accuracy. In other words, people know you, they know your background, and they look to you as a leader in your industry. They accept you as a good source of information for that particular topic. Okay, finally, there's trustworthiness. Trustworthiness is actually the most important part of Google EEAT SEO. Quality raters must consider the creator, the content, and the website when deciding if it's actually trustworthy. To enhance the trustworthiness of your website, be clear about who wrote your content. Edit for factual accuracy, cite trustworthy sources, and avoid hiding content behind an ugly and huge wall of ads. Keep in mind that this encompasses more than just the content, though. There's actually a technical aspect to trustworthiness, and if you're ever hanging out online, I'm sure you've seen it. In the Search Quality Rater guidelines, Google refers to low-quality content as spammy. So a million pop-ups and this famous dancing dude probably fall in this category. Now, a quick but important side note here. Experience, expertise, authoritativeness, and trustworthiness are important for all websites, but they are especially important if you're running a website with information about tsunami escape routes, or prescription drugs, or instructions on treating a poisonous snake bite, for example. These topics are what we call YMYL, your money or your life. And EEAT matters the most when it comes to these topics because, of course, getting stuff wrong can impact a reader's health, their financial stability, or even safety. And back to our regular programming. Now that you know what EEAT is, let's talk about how to improve yours. I'm going to use one of my favorite online publications to highlight some best practices here, the SEMrush blog. Yeah, I know I work there or here, but I promise it's really good. Objectively, it's very good. Okay. The first and most important thing that you can do for EEAT is to establish a topic or a series of topics that you want to build authority around. The more quality, helpful content you publish on a relevant topic, the more keywords and search queries you can rank for, and the more topical authority you can build. And authority is, of course, 1/4 of EEAT. So in the case of SEMrush, our blog is all about SEO and all topics related to marketing. Okay, now let's explore an article to look at more tangible best practices. The first thing that you're going to notice here is that we're very transparent about who wrote this article, both the main author and also the contributors. When you click on each of their names, you can learn more about who they are and what makes them qualified to write on our blog. My friend Carlos, for example, is a senior writer with over 8 years of experience in various digital marketing topics. You can see his expertise here and his education, as well as links to his profiles on social media in case you want to follow him on LinkedIn. So listen up. Author bios are super important. They tell the reader and also Google that the person writing a piece of content is a legit source of information. Now, a cool bonus thing that the SEMrush blog does, in addition to author profiles, at the very top here, we let you know that our articles are reviewed by experts. You can even click this link to view our editorial standards and our process. Now, that's great EEAT SEO. Okay, next up on our list of best practices, you should be citing credible sources. Studies, research papers, academic databases, news publications, or established experts and agency sites. The list of sources can also include user-generated content or UGC. This is any content that is created by consumers or website users rather than brands themselves. Now, let's take a look at an example. In this blog post about ranking factors, SEMrush is directly citing the source for each of these ranking factors and linking back to it. This, by the way, also helps give another site a backlink. And since I believe in karma, I think it's a kind and important thing to do, because what goes around comes around, even on the internet. Creating quality content around a core topic, sharing information about experts who are creating this content, and then linking to official sources. These are all things that you can do to establish EEAT on any page of your website or blog. But it's important to note that there are some off-page things that are important too. I'm talking about your brand and its reputation. It can really impact the trustworthiness of your site. This means that you need to keep an eye out for negative reviews or press about your business. If something does come up, which happens sometimes, respond promptly and professionally. Okay. Now that we've covered everything you need to know about Google's EEAT, let's take a minute to talk about three SEMrush tools that can really help you establish EEAT for your website or blog. First, the SEMrush Authority Score. SEMrush Authority Score is our compound metric used for measuring a domain or a web page's overall quality and SEO performance. It is based on a series of metrics that prove both trustworthiness and authority. Now, let me note that this is not a perfect indicator of authoritativeness as it relates to EEAT, but it does give you a general idea of where you and your website might rate. You can view your authority score or that of any domain on the internet by going to the domain overview tool. Ooh, Cool Math Games has an authority score of 82. I guess it goes to show that your website doesn't have to have super cool and modern graphics to have a high authority score. Okay, SEMrush tool number two. If you've decided on a pillar topic, you can use the topic research tool to find content ideas that you can write about to develop your authority. And finally, tool number three, if you already have a draft of a blog post, you can drop it into the SEO writing assistant and check for readability, SEO, originality, and tone of voice. The suggestions that this tool provides can help make your writing a lot more helpful. Finally, since this video is all about experience, expertise, authoritativeness, and trustworthiness, as your humble YouTube host, I thought I would take a moment to tell you a little bit about me and why I'm qualified to be sitting here in front of this camera. I have over 15 years of experience leading marketing teams for a variety of global brands. I have run my own successful e-commerce business. I've also been teaching marketing for almost a decade to both adult learners and college students around the world. Was that too much of a humble brag? I do it all for EEAT. If you want to build more authority for your site, we have a course for that on SEMrush Academy. I put the link below in the description. You also get a certificate when you complete it, which is awesome for LinkedIn fodder. Okay, that's all for today. See you next time.